Hey, Don here. Okay, so here is easy to boot. The boot menu on my Lenovo i5 running off of the SD card and the USB adapter. And this is a multi-boot system. You can just put in the ISOs in the certain folders, and then you can boot from the ISOs. That you downloaded whatever operating system you want to boot to. And I have three Windows 7 install ISOs in here, and I don't have anything else, but you can do Linux and other FreeBSD and stuff like that. And so I thought I would, this is a continuation of my, while I was setting it up. I did those desktop videos, because I could do that. Of course, here on the actual, I was doing that in a virtual machine. I did the install in a virtual machine in Windows XP on my Linux, Fedora 23 Linux system. And so this is that same computer. It's a Lenovo i5 with 4 gig of RAM and quad core. It only has 256 megabyte of onboard video memory, though, but it should work. It was pretty slow at loading there in my virtual machine. Of course, I was using up. It only had well, that was actually loading in Quemu, a virtual. I was running Windows XP in VirtualBox and then running this easy to boot in Quemu inside a VirtualBox. So it only had like I had a gig of RAM in XP, and then 344 megabytes of that was being used in Quemu. So there you go. And it was all running on one core of the processor, so because I went over text the actual hardware machine. So we'll see if it's any faster. And I think there's it says DOS menu and all that stuff, utilities. Oh, they're all empty. It tells you if there's anything in there. See, because I haven't put anything in there yet. But they give you these basic menus, and then you can put what you want to in the folders, what you want to actually use. But see, there it says the one that's red now, Windows Install menu. There's three present, and of course the other things help boot to the first hard HDD. The top one says set default menu entry and timeout. So I guess you can do that from here instead of having to do it like in the config files ahead of time. You can just I noticed that it searches your folders when you go into each one. Down there, and so that's how it. That's what should be kind of good about it, is that you can just add or remove ISOs, and it will as soon as you boot back up, it'll find them or that they're there or not there. So it's not a lot of. You don't have to do any config file editing or running the program again, like with Sardu or Yummy. You can do that, but you have to run the program again, and it takes a while to. Sometimes 30 minutes an hour, depending on how much you're doing to. Add and take away the other ISOs, so out of the boot menus and all that, because it's got to do a lot of it has to extract the ISOs. And this one works in a way that it doesn't have to extract the ISOs to make them boot, or at least a lot of them it doesn't. It's a lot more to it, a lot more complicated to understand. So I spent a long actually I ended up making about 2.5 hours of videos of basically real-time videos while I was doing it. And of course I spent a couple of days reading and researching a few hours, like 3 hours here and 2 hours there and like that, or more, really more probably, before I even started. And I still I made it a little harder because I didn't want to reformat my SD card because I already had files on, I already had all my Windows 7 ISOs on there. And so I did it I had to kind of go from page to page, like five, six different pages, to get figured out how to do it without having to reformat my SD card. They give you a program, a script that'll do it for you in this easy to boot setup, but in the files that comes with it. You just download it, unzip it, and run the stuff from there. It's not an install type of setup. But anyway, at the bottom, I'm sitting here on the Windows Install menu, three present. It also tells you the shortcut keys that you could use on your keyboard. And at the bottom down there, in the yellow, close to the bottom, install Windows to hard disk using an ISO or IMG PDN file. Now you can make those, convert your ISOs to IMG PDN files with another program that they have on their site. Actually, RM Prep USB is where I found this. It's a program that I've used for years, and it's a Windows program. It doesn't run in Linux. And anyway, I've used it on and off for years. It would only do one ISO at a time. Now this Easy Boot will do a bunch, you know, many as you got space on your drive for. Yeah, it's basically set up for a USB stick, but when I put my SD card in this USB, it's actually a micro SD card for a phone, you know. You put it in the USB adapter that came with, well, I actually have three cards, different ones. This adapter came with a different brand, but this other brand works fine in there. So anyway, sorry, I thought I was going to try not to cough, but can't help it sometimes with all these allergies. So, I think I better get a drink before I keep doing it. Let me see if I can get a drink. I would restart the video, but then you got to re-explain stuff, and I take too long to explain as it is. Okay, sorry. Anyway, at the bottom you get some other, you know, back reboot and stuff, power off. So let's hit the. I'm just going to hit enter on the Windows install and see what it does there. Okay, yeah, that was taking a while to load up on the virtual machine, but that was just instant right there. Of course, I'll tell you this, I forgot and left it in machine last night this morning when I went to bed. I didn't go to bed till 7 this morning after I made my last desktop video. Then when it was finished, I was waiting for it to finish making the files contiguous. It actually took about 2 to 3. So I looked at it at 2 hours, it wasn't done, and then at 4 hours I looked at it again and it was done. So I don't know when exactly it quit, but so it does take a while. You have to do that step to make it work too. And it's you can either do it from RM Prep USB or from a CMD file that's in the directory there of Easy Boot. And I did it with RM Prep USB. I don't know if that would have been faster the other way or not. Next time I may try it. Okay, list disks. Okay, 64-bit CPU, sorry. I guess that's telling what I have here, and because I know it's a 64-bit. 1511 megabyte. 1511 megabyte. I don't know what that's supposed to mean. I have 4 gig of RAM, so it's not the RAM. I only have 256 megabytes of video memory, so it's not that. So I don't know. Maybe it's the cache in the CPU. I really don't know what it is on this. So then, of course, you can go boot the first hard disk back, reboot off, all that. So I'm going to go in there and look at. Okay, there we go. Well, that's nice and quick. Okay. Of course, it may have. I know the first time I booted it up, it did. Took a while to search. Several minutes. Five, 10 minutes. I don't know. I was kind of talking and making the video while it was happening. Seemed forever because I was waiting on it, but it might have been just like 2 or 3 minutes. Anyway, it was searching all the folders for ISOs, and then it populated the menus before you could boot, actually click on them. But see, it's been sitting here for. I booted at the machine and went off in the other room ended up staying for a couple hours, so it had time to do all that while I was gone. So I really don't know how long it would have taken. Plus, it had already been done before, so maybe it didn't even have to be do it again. I don't know. Find that out later, I guess. So I've got Windows 7 Professional 64-bit, which is what I would put on this machine. I already have it on there, and it's infected with viruses, and that's the whole thing, is I'm getting ready to reformat. I kind of had started thinking I need this space anyway for my Linux system, so I may just I've got Fedora 23, and I want to go to 24. Could just upgrade, but I may reformat the whole thing and just fill. It's only a 250 gigabyte hard drive. I may fill it with Linux so I have more space to work with, because I really only really want or need one Windows 7 machine. I don't really need three like I had. They're all but one was dual boots machines, and I tend to not want to do that. If it's got Linux, that's what I really want to use. So that one machine that I have, that I call it ASRock because I have ASRock motherboard in it, it was Windows only, and I would just boot it up and then use VNC remote desktop to control it from whatever machine I was on. And that was working out pretty well. So that's the one I may reformat. I actually been trying to save it and not have to reformat it because from all the viruses, because I have all my video files backed up on there from my phones. I don't have another place to put them right now. But I could do have one little 30 gig hard drive that I could. That'd be just enough. I was thinking I'd just put a Linux distro on it just so that I can access the files, but I could actually put Windows 7 on it and just not really install many apps or anything. That'll take about 10 to 12, maybe even 15 gigabyte just to get 7 up and running. And a couple of apps that makes it usable, you know, a few apps or 4, 5, or 10. But anyway, I think it already has 64-bit. Let's see, which one? I don't know. Probably 64-bit professional on there. And then there's x86, which, you know, is 32-bit, which is what I had on my laptop. I'm trying to remember. I have a couple of, I have some 7 home ISOs too. I'm thinking the only one I remember for sure being pro was this one. So I may have been thinking when I put all these in there, it's been a while since I put them on my SD card and I did other things over the last month or so. So I might have just put the ones I thought I needed for this one, and now I'm beginning to change my mind. And well, I'm not so sure that other AS Rock machine is a pro version. I mean, whatever the license is, that's what you have to use. So the license you have for that machine. So anyway, I'm going to boot into 7 Professional 64 because that's probably what this is. And the OEM DVD, I don't remember what the big difference is there. It may have 32 and 64-bit on it. I don't remember. Or it may be, I don't know, I'll just have to boot into it and see what it is now because I can't remember. But let's boot into it and see what happens here. See if it boots right. Okay, so you get this screen and it says, please choose Escape Freeboard or Zero for Easy Boot XML file. Full language, so you can choose your language, I'm sure. Load ISO, no prompt to repair. I guess it would just start trying to repair it. Sample, I don't know what that is. And Win 7 Pro Auto Wipe Disk. I wouldn't want to do that on this one for sure. I don't want it wiping my Linux system. So, trying to look over the phone here and find my O on the keyboard, a 0. Okay, now, this is something that I didn't expect because I have, from what I understood, if you have a removable disk type, if your SD card or USB stick is for the of the removable disk type, then you won't have any problems with what it sounds like it's saying here. Windows 7 Professional SP 64X, I can't say it right. Professional, anyway, you can read it faster than I can. Well, if you can read it, you probably can't. This is the phone, I forget. Using Windows 7 Professional X64 SP bootable. So-and-so numbers, ISO with ISO ETB, fair disk, AU, XML. Okay. Warning, to install Windows from a USB hard disk, you also need an ETB helper USB flash drive. Oh, well, this is not a USB hard disk. This is a... Okay, if you do not have one, you will get a DVD drive device. DVD drive device driver is missing message. Please read the Easy to Boot tutorial for more details. Okay, so it's just a standard warning. C to continue or enter to return. Okay, so you want to hit C, not enter. I would have normally just hit enter. C. So, yeah, if you had a USB hard drive, which I do have a hard drive I used to put on a USB adapter, which makes it a USB hard drive, you would need another, another, but you have to use their app to build another USB stick to put a long end to boot to it and then have your files on, I guess, this one, you know. But since mine's the removable type, you also may get that. I think you've seen you'd get that if it was fixed disc type, you would get this problem too. So it said, do you recommend you using a removable type? Well, I was lucky enough that mine already was a removable type. You know, I wasn't going to, it's what I had and what I was going to use no matter what, if it would work. So, there it goes, it's loading up. Now, on that virtual machine, it stuck it about a quarter of the way through for about 10 minutes. And I finally just, you know, gave up on it. It got up to about a third of the way through before I gave up. But you know, I didn't expect it to really fully load in 344 megabyte. It actually started using up the memory in my virtual machine, and it lost the desktop and everything before I got out of it. But it was still responding and working though. But yeah, there we go, starting Windows. And of course, I'm not going to do this. I'm just going to see how it looks. And see if it looks like it would run, so I'll know that I can do this. Especially if I choose to restore this Windows. Let's see. Okay, found a USB drive at F. IM disk drive installed successfully. Looking for FISO's Windows 7 Professional. Okay, mounting it. Creating device. Sorry. And I guess I could put that up a little closer. Found C sources, found Y sources, install, repair, start, rep, execute, found, recovery environment, found. Repair Windows, startup repair, recovery Windows, startup repair system, restore. Can't read it with my phone in the way of myself. Okay, and then in install Windows setup. Choose an option, press enter or in to install Windows. Okay, so this is actually as far as I'm going to go because I had to basically kind of decided to give up on this and reformat it on scanning it for viruses because I just kept coming up with them. I scanned at least six times because, or like I said, I may just blow it off and just go full Linux on this one. And so I don't really want to repair it. And I don't think I really have any files in there that I need to recover. Personal files and stuff, but I don't want to do anything that could lose them until I'm sure about that. So it looks like it would work, and I might be able to. Oh yeah, Windows startup is broken on this. I wouldn't mind if I fix that, it'll break my grub. If you have a dual boot system, if you ever do break the Windows startup, if you go and fix it with the Windows repair, it will break your grub boot menu. Because it will overwrite your MBR, so you don't want to do that unless you really have to. Because what you'll have to do is go use a grub repair disk, which is not too hard. But I don't even need to boot into this Windows system, so I don't want to do that. But I tried fixing it with a grub repair disk, and it couldn't fix it. So I figured that Windows might be completely broken anyway. All those virus scans I did probably deleted. Some of the scanners don't tell you a good detailed list of what they're deleting. So could have deleted Windows system files. So you're just trying to fix the boot. May not, you know, the system still might not boot. And like I said, I don't even want to boot into it because I'm not sure it's clean. And if I booted into it, it would just spread some more. So as long as I know my personal files are clean, that I might want to save out of there. I can get them out of there by mounting the NTFS drive within my Linux system and copying them over. So anyway, let's see. How will I reboot? That's all I really want to do. Repair, recovery, test, command prompt. Install Windows. It looks like I don't have a good exit command in here. There is more to all this. Yeah, there's a lot more. No, just blue below there. Well, how funny. Okay, but this is a blue terminal window is all it is. And Yeah, no, I guess escape would exit. Let's hit escape. I started to say I'd just close it. Let's go up here and hit the X, but I think I'll hit escape because I remember reading something. That's usually what you do anyway if you want to get out of something. It says escape. Ah, doesn't seem to have done anything. It still acts like it's thinking it. It's got that icon spinning up there. It might be getting ready to go into a default mode and do it anyway. Okay, yeah, I closed it. Windows could not apply the Windows PE bootstrap setting specified in the unattended answer file. That's because of me closing that, I'm sure. Okay, now I think it'll say, it's just going to shut down or reboot. Probably reboot. Yeah. So I want to go into the... we'll get to see just what it does when it's booting them. Of course, it's real quick now because it's already scanned them. But there's no other ones to look at other than you can see the other menus. But so I won't go into there. But the one that has three present, that's this one. And okay, yeah, so it goes right in there quickly since it's already got the directory scanned. Okay, and... Okay, Windows 7 Pro. I want to see what that is. See what version, if I can tell what version it is. Okay, easy to boot. Same thing again. I just want to hit 0. Where's 0? 0, 0. Okay. Hit 0. Hit enter. And this time I know, we'll see. But I have to hit C, not... Makes it look like a D with the cursor beside it, but it's a C. Hit C, not enter. I'll just almost hit enter without thinking. Okay, it's working. Just to find out that my ISOs are going to boot and that they're good is main thing here. And I'll have to look at the license keys on each one and see if I can even use. All I have to do is copy my other. Like if I need home or whatever, I can copy those ISOs into this SD card. And if I run out of space, it's a 32 gig, so I have space. But if I run out of space, I can always just delete one. And then when it boots up, it'll see what's gone and see what's there. So that's pretty cool. I think maybe this is working out. I won't know for sure until I actually run a full install because, say with Yummy, you know, it'll boot Fedora and stuff and a lot of distros really well live. But then if you try to, you can't install Fedora. It'll error out on you. It warns you on the website not to try that. But I tried it without reading all the information because I'd used it for years. Okay, there it is. Same screen. So it's not going to tell me anymore. Only thing that I this is just the file name I gave this ISO. So this one may be the only one I could really use. Well, I mean, I could use the other ones for repairs, but for a brand new install, I may have to use this one. That's what I'm thinking. Not sure. Can't remember. It's been so long, a while. It ain't been all that long, a year or so, but since maybe even not that long since I installed one, but I can't remember. I do stuff on computers all day long, and it's almost all Linux, so I forget the Windows stuff. I'd kind of rather forget it. I don't like to mess with it. It's always nothing but trouble. So it's all the same thing. But hitting escape didn't do me any good. I might be able to get in there and type reboot or something, but no point in that since I can just do that. I think I'm gonna just try the other one too while I'm here, just to see that it works. See that it's not like corrupted to where it won't boot or anything. And then, and then I will, let's see, very present. I'm really pleased with this, though. I think it's going to work out. Now, I've already tried the 64 and the 7 Pro OEM. I guess I wouldn't know until I ran it if it was, if you got the choice of just x86, 64, or both, either or. And okay, and so now same thing. Oh, I can't see the this time the menu didn't come up good. Can't, if I didn't know the letters already, I would be kind of at a loss. I don't know why that happened this time, but I know it's zero. I want that, so I'll do that. And then I gotta hit C. Okay. That's kind of that does happen sometimes. I don't. You would think just rebooting it wouldn't mess up your syncing on the monitor, you know, the size, but it does sometimes. Oh, I'm getting mesmerized here. Forgot to say anything, didn't I? Well, I didn't have anything to say anyway. Okay. It's adjusting now. Okay. Setup is starting. Seems different. Or is it just me? I guess I just hadn't paid enough attention yet. It's exactly the same. So what it looks like. So you just need to... Either you need to know what ISO you're using, make sure your names are... I gave it the names to tell me what's what, except for... Now, I think I probably had that OEM one first, and then later I downloaded the other two because I had different machines that some, you know, like my laptop, I don't think it will do 64-bit, and then this one will. I think that AS... I'm pretty sure that AS Rock will do 64-bit, but so I think that's why... And that OEM one was probably the one I originally used to put on the laptop, what I'm thinking. So anyway, I wonder if I could just type shutdown in there. Now I can't remember if it's supposed to be two words or one. I typed it two words. It doesn't work, I'll just do whatever. Oh, look at that. It went into there anyway. Collecting information, installing Windows. Now that was weird. It's wanting to go ahead and install it, but I don't want it to do that. So I'm just gonna close it now. To install or upgrade Windows, you must run Windows installation. Are you sure you want to cancel? Yes, I want to cancel. Okay, now it'll probably just reboot again. Boy, I'm having a hard time. My left hand's been holding the phone there. I had to assist it for a while, but... Oh, it's stiff, and I couldn't... I'm about ready to just let go involuntarily. Phone don't weigh very much, but holding still. And that's even with my elbow sitting on the arm of the chair. Okay, so... Yeah, so DOS menu, DOS, uno, DOS... Trace, DOS, boot to first hard drive, back, free DOS from floppy image, boot first hard drive, reboot, power off. Okay, so that's what's going to happen when you get into these menus. Oh, F8 would take you back. Okay, yeah, that's what I was wondering is. So then I can go back. So, you know, there's nothing to go to in any of these other menus. Help might be interesting, but I'm just going to hit power off here from the main menu and go about my regular work because I'm not going to do any installation right now. And this is not the machine I'd do it on anyway, so I don't think. So there you go. There's easy to boot working. And if you want to see how I... got it to install or set up, I would say it's not installed. I got it set up on a SD card and a USB adapter and didn't FAT32 formatted already. I didn't have to reformat it. Then you can look at my previous desktop videos. I'll name them all the same about easy to boot, you know, and all that. and what I just, all the stuff I just said, I'll kind of try to make a name that explains what it is. So, and you know, I'll if I upload them on YouTube, then I can put stuff in, you know, stuff links or just or where I tell you how if they let you put links in there anymore. Anyway, I'll make a way to find them in the description. Okay, this is Don. Thanks. Bye.